So, what will it be, Major? What?
Shit, would you look at that? It's that thing again.
Be careful. Hog 7 units are quite dangerous.
Oh, come on. It's freaking adorable.
authorization, Major Nechayev. Access granted. Please select the desired procedure. Please select the desired procedure.
Shit, would you look at that? It's that thing again.
Be careful. Hog 7 units are quite dangerous.
Oh, come on. It's freaking adorable. Look at that, it's that thing again.
Be careful. Hog 7 units are quite dangerous.
Oh, come on, it's freaking...
Whoa.
electromagnetic clusters.
I can use an EMP on them. Kill me, is it?
Let's hope not, comrade.
That's crazy.
Comrade Major, have you made it to the VDNH?
Kinda.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I'm kinda almost there. I'm in the magnetic shock absorption chamber, looking for a way to unlock the entrance doors. Can you open them for me?
No, I can't. I don't have the skills. This is your responsibility.
Then get off my grill. Clumsy asshole! Another door without a lock. Ugh. Where's the relay, Charles?
I don't see anything on the walls.
What's the point of this fucking maze anyway?
The magnetic shock absorption system was developed by scientists from Kiev Polytechnic University. It's a very complex and comprehensive device that alters its configuration according to the situation.
So it's Plan B in case of a natural disaster.
Among other things. But it is first and foremost a trial run of the magnetic shock absorption system. Here, under Earth conditions, the system will be perfected so that it can be deployed in space.
Cool. Science is power. There's no denying it. But we still need to find a way past all these goddamn magnets.
Thank you.
Those freaks and their goddamn mustaches again. What you staring at, you metal dipshit? Charles, what the hell does Molotov have against Dr. Sechenov? Why do you have to cook this commission up 2 days before the launch of... Everything's ready.
Exactly, because everything is ready.
What do you mean? Are you trying to say that Molotov...
for showing that Dr. Sechenov is incapable of overseeing Facility 3826, and by extension, the polymerization of the Soviet Union.
What's the boss got to do with it? Chekhov's fault. He's the one who made the robots turn the...
care how many victims there are, but neither does Comrade Sechenov.
What? What the fuck are you talking about? This.
To be precise, Comrade Major, it's you... pending information about this terrible malfunction becoming known to the rest of the world.
Because no one would believe that a handful of traitors are responsible for the whole thing. Everybody would think that Soviet robots are dangerous.
Quite right. But what conclusion should we draw from this? Only that, hypothetically, Comrades Sechenov and Molotov should both have a vested interest in ending this nightmare quickly as possible. Isn't that right?
Yeah. So what?
We're seeing a common, everyday power struggle. Instead of going to the government and having troops sent to Facility 3826 to destroy the hostile robots, arrest Petrov, or end this in some other way, Dr. Sechenov is doing... feel the tragedy for everyone, including the government.
They can't send in the army. There are too many people. Somebody could leak intel to the enemy and then it's all over.
But only reliable men could be sent to the facility, such as the Argentum unit loyal to Sechenov. They could team up with combat robots and restore order in the blink of an eye. But I don't need to tell you about that, do I?
But that's, I mean, ugh, crispy critters. I don't get it. Why does it have to be so complicated?
Because Dr. Sechenov can't deploy troops or combat robots without the authorization of the Politburo. On the contrary, he's doing everything he can to make sure the government doesn't know what happened. Why do you think that is?
Because his enemies would take Collective away from him? Now, when everything's built and ready to go, and any asshole with a badge could run it.
Quite right. It's all done. Just fix the malfunction and press a button. Geniuses, creators, and engineers have already done their jobs. All that's left to do is enjoy the fruits of their labor.
In other words, Comrade Molotov wants to put Dr. Sechenov in jail over what happened here so he can take over the facility himself?
To be exact, he wants to lead Collective.
But how can he? Everybody's going to be equal there.
Some will be more equal than others.
No, I know that high-ranking Communist Party members will have more authority in Collective than ordinary citizens, but that's fine. I mean, somebody's got to make big decisions, right?
Is that so? Why, pray tell?
Well, first off, somebody has to be responsible for carrying them out. It's not like everyone can be responsible for everything. Everyone means no one. Someone's got to take responsibility. The buck has to stop somewhere, right? And if the whole world did nothing but debate big decisions, no one would ever do anything. They'd spend all their time talking.
But what if you're wrong? You say that the entire stop discussing important decisions. Collective is a collective mind. Responsibility will be determined not by fear of punishment, but by awareness.
Has anyone ever reached that level, even here in the USSR? We're not perfect, to say nothing of the rest of the world.
Absolutely right. Ready for the launch of Collective. The Soviet Union's leaders understand this. That's why the party will have special discretionary authority within Collective.
What's wrong with that? That's how it's always been.
Has it really? Or has there always been one indisputable leader? A puppet master controlling the Politburo, the Council of Ministers, and all the rest?
Are you trying to say there's gonna be one single leader in Collective?
I'm trying to say that people will connect to Collective via a neuroconnector.
You mean a thought device? Everyone knows that.
The thought device is for ordinary citizens. But individuals in privileged leadership positions will have special engraved connectors that grant them a higher priority on the network.
So even the leaders will be equal. That's a good thing, right?
It would be. But Collective can only be launched via the Alpha Connector. It's the key to everything, including assigning discretionary authority.
So Dr. Sechenov has the Alpha Connector right now, and Comrade Molotov wants to kick him out of the facility so he can take the Alpha Connector for himself.
Exactly. The number of people killed here as a result of Petrov's betrayal is a precious little concern to Comrade Molotov. He wants to take control of Collective. That's why he's on his way here right now.
Crispy critters. I never liked that guy. He's always complaining about Sechenov, but I never expected shit like this from him. We gotta hurry.
Saving data.
I'm confused. How you got titties and a mustache? Look, titties and a mustache. What the fuck?
So this little thing is the reason everything's all jammed up? This place is nuts.
You can ascend to the surface along with the mirror.
For once, you're right. I'd probably reach Nirvana before I could make it back down the way I came.
Have you infiltrated the VDNH yet, Comrade Major? The government's commission's Condor has already left Moscow. They'll be here any minute now.
If the commission hasn't landed yet, that means there's still time. Just let me work in peace.
Shall I report to Dr. Sechenov that it is his requests that prevent you from working?
Yeah, you can report on how you ran away from those robots on the maglev platform instead of helping.
I am not a soldier, Comrade Major. I am doing intellectual, not menial labor. Smashing robots is your specialty.
The only labor you're doing is talking my ear off. Right now you're wasting my time and slowing down my mission. What?
Nothing.
That's what I thought.
Damn, all these people died. That shit crazy. Boom.
Looking at this worthless hunk of junk, the backstabbing machine that killed me.
It's a phase. It'll pass.
It's already passing. I can't even remember my own name anymore. But his metal mug is still there. I still remember the bastard gutting me. They told us robots were going to replace us. As staff, I mean. Well, they certainly did. Only they did it by slaughtering us all. That's some replacement, isn't it? Oh well. Just leave me alone. I want to doze off.
Dead bodies all over the place. There's Tereshkova's arm. What's that metal pervert doing with it?
That is a robot waiter.
Who's serving the people it killed? I'm gonna smash that fucking bot to bits.
The robot isn't currently hostile. We should be able to retrieve the arm without a fight.
Alive.
Everyone, I took a look at some recordings of your tours. why are they so boring? Graphics are this and that kind of robot, yada, yada, yada. And then you get all technical. There are kids there, you know? Young pioneers, Octopris. You gotta keep them entertained. Yeah, watch this. This is Robot Rapping. He's really nice and friendly. You know what I mean. Don't say he kicks ass. Say, I don't know, something else. Make the tours fun. Let the little buggers crawl all over the bots. Let them ride them or something. I don't know. They're safe and fun. We need to get the kids interested in robots, not put them to sleep.
How does it work?
Hold it up to my neurosensor contacts. Multi-key activated.
Now what?
Thank you for coming to my aid. Not having the key felt like I was missing a...
Pipe down.
Greetings, comrades, and welcome to the All-Soviet Exhibition Center!
What the fuck are you babbling on about? What speech?
You're prancing past piles of dead bodies, and there's blood everywhere.
My algorithms are glitching with horror, but my databases lack the verbal and visual tools required to express fear, horror, or other negative emotions. I was created to remain positive and optimistic, no matter what. The grotesque dissonance between my behavior and the gruesome surroundings grosses me out, but there's nothing I can do about it.
I see. I guess nobody expected this to happen. Okay, bot. Set the VDNH to drill mode.
Drill mode? This would lead to even greater aggression from passive and physical security systems. It will endanger you, and may lead to death of the surviving people, assuming there are still any left.
Exactly. If there are any left, this place is a fucking graveyard. Now follow my damn order, bot.
You have given me a most peculiar command. All people in this my robots, but you are
And how am I supposed to do that? Commit seppuku?
You must pass the Darwin test. This way.
What the f-
without her?
Fine.
Prove.
Crispy critters. Now I gotta deal with another crazy ass lock. Fuck. I'm a magnet for annoying bullshit.